Okay, we're back for turn 17 of the eight-wheeled handicap. What are we expecting here? Well, not an amazing amount. We just dropped some artillery in this area because there was a sound contact, which has now jumped back over here, so who knows what's going on with that. We are plotting some of the pixel trapping up here on the ridge line to see if we can't, you know, get some kind of reaction from the enemy in this kind of area. There's still, in theory, a BTR and a load of infantry hanging around here, and the guys in the A-team house, the A-team, are still there, and they're still going. How long that's going to last, though, since they are essentially surrounded by Russians, I don't know. But if they get any trouble, we're just going to RT the problem. Yeah, we're not expecting any pre-planned RT. We're past that stage now. It's possible that we might have some enemy air attack in the works. Maybe, who knows? Like I've been saying the last couple of turns, we're in that stage where it looks like we're pretty much both grabbed the ground that we want to get. And now it's going to be up to one or both of us to leave our nice, safe, easily defensible position and risk attacking the other guy. And what with the fact that I have a light infantry force here, but with a few extra wheels, I'm not massively confident in my ability to attack a mechanized infantry force with armor. But we'll see how it pans out. So let's just press go and we'll see what we get here. We've also been once again trying to javelin that BTR on top of the hill there, and this team just keeps losing sight, which is rather annoying. And ooh, hello, spotting contacts, ahoy. Have to see who's spotting that. There is a dead BTR up there, I think, so it might just be something like that. I'm gonna get a few bits of a few infantry spots over there, and that tank spots back, but that was a dead tank, so yeah, very quiet turn. Not too surprising. Black Sea is a bit like that. You don't really get the extended firefights that you get in Normandy and things, because everything just dies. There's no kind of... I think that's... Yeah, look, that's just the BTR. We've just lost sight of that. That icon is that burning T-90 up there. Here we had some infantry contacts around here, but some of them probably got atomized by the arty. I don't. Oh no, 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 no. There was some. Did spot somebody. It's probably this lone, very unfortunate, very uncomfortable, panicking crewman. And, oh yeah, we did get quite a lot, we just didn't hear it from all the way up there. Okay, so where was that fire coming in? Was that the top floor? Yeah, that looks like it might be area fire on the top floor from this BTR in here. Yeah, judging from the line, yeah, see, we're hitting the trees, we're hitting the wall, we're hitting the back wall. It's that BTR in there. Which we have lost sight of. But that's just some kind of... Who spotted it? Ah, Mr. Javelin spotted it. How about you kill that BTR? That would be awesome. Somebody's got a job to do on the next turn. And apart from that, have we got any spotting contacts down here? Nope. Nope. What are you guys hearing? Nothing. So these guys have literally walked along the slope here. And nobody's shot them up or anything, and they haven't seen anything. So we're just going to leave them there for a turn or two. They can kind of eyeball down into the saddle here. If they spot anything, TRP. So we'll be able to bomb it in about 2 minutes. Very, very quickly. And if they get any problems, they should be able to leg it back over the ridgeline. I'm kind of caught with the scouting here. I know I need to push out more bodies to get more eyes on what's going on. But at the same time, I have such a small, or it feels like I have such a small force. I have 3 platoons. And that's not a lot. One rule I've heard in this kind of thing is you should devote at least a third of your force to reconnaissance so you can find the enemy, but reconnaissance in this can be punished quite heavily, quite quickly. So I'm not a massive fan of that concept. And at the same time, I need to actually go forward, so it's not fantastic. In terms of plans here, that's what happens when you double click. We need to at least secure one objective here. Of these two objectives, the one that's going to be easiest to secure is going to be this one. If I turn the trees off. Because if we look at the area we've got to secure, we've got to secure this stream bed, which we've secured. This road, which is clear because we are covering it. The second stream bed on the other side of the ridge, which we can call in artillery on directly. And is screened off to some extent from enemy forces further back on the other side. And we've got to secure this road here with the tree line. Now, securing this bit of forward slope means we've got to come up here in force and dominate the hillside here and potentially also these this orchard or tree farm or whatever. Potentially. And it could be enough if we get a squad up here so we can get some eyes on this area and then just if we find any enemies we can destroy them and then any support coming their way from across the fields it could be javelin o'clock. Potentially. I'm not making this sound good, but it's probably better than trying to secure Chigalivka, or whatever we're calling it, over here, where we'd have to control all of these roads. So we have to control the rail line, we'll have to control this road here, these two roads going through the centre of town, and this edge of the village here, which means I have to clear out all of this stuff. All of this stuff here. And it's also a very obvious location for AjarmanG to dig in on. So I'm kind of angling, I'm thinking more about going for objective 2 and securing this bridge or set of bridges over the river. Again, we've got the reverse slope so we can get quite close to the enemy without giving the game away. We're going to have artillery support and you know, we have this. We can get up close using the reverse slope and try and minimize the casualties, at least to some extent. We've also got this kind of crossfire going on. If these guys move up forward, they can cover off the front of this force as this force moves forward. Yeah, if that makes sense. And if we kind of grab this hillside, or this hilltop on this side, we can cover them into the objective area as well. So that's a kind of very reasonable plan of attack there. Over here, if we were going to try and attack the village, we probably, from this position, we can't attack from here because this is scary, scary open ground. We're not going to be attacking across this bridge because that's going to end badly. To reposition the forces to get over there, we'd have to either go all the way around the back here. So the troops would be out of the fight for a considerable amount of time. So if we do get a problem, we wouldn't be able to react to it. Or it'd be an exercise in attacking up the river, which is a long way to go. It's going to telegraph the attack to AjarmanG. We've got to attack through a serious obstacle, which is this Y junction in the stream with all the trees around it. There is a TRP actually here underneath at the confluence there. That's the posh name for it. And we've got one right next to it, so we've got some artillery support, but in the actual objective area, not so much. We've got these bits here, and we do have some help here because we've got the A-team, which is sitting there preparing to die. But, you know, we've got to attack through here, and then we've got to attack into the town, and it'd just be really, really messy. Whereas over here, we've got pretty much seize these two hilltops, and then lots of artillery and everything, and pretty much done. We can try and clear the objective out by massive fires. So that's what I'm thinking of. Also, you know, because of the reverse slope, because of this gorgeous, gorgeous ridgeline, you know, we can transfer these forces around pretty much with impunity. I don't think he's got a drone up because we would have shut it down by now, but if these guys travel around down here, he's got no idea what's coming. We're trailing off to the right there because I forgot where the mouse was. And of course, he's not gonna know the strength of the attack that's moving in. It might just be a platoon, it might be a couple of squads or a fire team, something like that, just moving up to get eyes on this area. So he doesn't know how strong we are elsewhere. And if we do have a problem, say if I shuffle this platoon out, we swap them round to here to push the objective 2, and we start getting problems in this area, we've got the arty for the immediate bacon saving, and then the guys can hop in the strikers, bomb back down this way, and be in position again in a couple of turns. So that's kind of where I'm angling here. We could even potentially take this squad, whack him in that javelin, and send them around the back. The back of everything. Bring him up here. Just do a quick patrol. Bring a striker with him, but keep it quiet. Or even potentially start moving these guys up to have a look. But yeah, you see where I'm coming from here. This is a much safer option to attack, despite the fact that it's 90% open ground. So that's kind of the direction I'm thinking of here. Not just in a tactic sense, not just tactically speaking, because obviously we want to keep trying to impose our will on the enemy. We want to retain the initiative that we've got here. But also because of simple gameplay reasons. You know, if we both sit here and we both dig in, then we're going to have all kinds of... it's going to take the momentum out of the game. And we want to keep that going by doing something exciting. So, yeah, let's press done there. Those guys are going to stay there. Mr. Javelin here is going to stop where he is. Kill that BTR. Who can see that one? Those guys can. Oh, you can see that one. Oh, he doesn't have any javelins. That's why he's not killing anything. Ah, oh, God. Duh. Hapless, you idiot. crawl you back into that building then. Yeah, our sole remaining anti-tank weapon here is we've got 2 AT4s, which is great. They look like they've buddy aged, but they didn't pick up the didn't pick up the damn grenade launcher. That's a pity. So yeah, these guys are clearly not particularly in a position to, you know, we can spot that BTR every now and again, but when we see it, it just goes away. So I think it's probably time. Let's crawl them out of position and bomb them back into there. You guys come back as well. You guys need to get back in there. And which squad are you? Second squad. Second squad. Right. Let's leapfrog the B team here and push them up to the edge of this tree line to see what happens. Not the world's best strategy, I know, but we need to get some eyes on there somehow. There is at least another T-90 up here. At least one more T-90. Pretty sure that there are two. And we really want to stay out of his line of sight, otherwise we're going to have a real bad day. The A-team is just going to have to suck it up and get shot at. We're still controlling this bridge. This guy is still hiding in the objective. Lots of artillery left. Yeah, that will do. Let's press go. And we're back on a roll.